Hi, welcome to my channel. I'll be showing you how to crochet an I-cord and how to switch yarns if you want to make it multicolored. I'll also show you how to make this barrel knot and give you some tips if you plan on using your I-cord as a drawstring. Crocheting an I-cord is really easy and repetitive once you get the hang of it. It's all about getting used to the finger positioning, which I'll go over in detail. To make an I-cord, you'll need the following supplies. You'll need some yarn. You can use any size you'd like. I used an assortment of these medium weight cotton yarns to make my drawstring. I'll put links to the colors along with additional information in the description. You'll also need a crochet hook. With I-cords, I recommend going one full hook size smaller than what's recommended on the yarn label. This will give you a tighter stitch, which is better if you're going to be putting any kind of weight or tension on your cord, like using it for a drawstring or strap. Since my yarn label recommends a 5mm hook, I'm going to be using a 4mm hook instead. You'll also need some scissors, a tapestry needle to sew in your ends, and if you're planning on turning your cord into a drawstring, you'll need a large safety pin to thread it. I also have one of these very handy drawstring threaders, which I highly recommend as having a staple in your sewing kit, but you can make do with just a safety pin if you don't have one. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to get started on this tube yarn. It's easier for you to see the stitches and where your hook has to go. As much as I love the beautiful colors of my stranded cotton yarn, the strands tend to split apart, so you really need some patience when you're working with that type of yarn. You'll start by making a slip knot. The way I do it is I make a crossover and then pull the yarn through the center. Place it on your hook and give it a tug to tighten. Then make a chain by wrapping your yarn over the hook and pulling through the loop that's on your hook. That's the first chain. For this tutorial, I'm going to be making a total of 3 chains. You can make more than that for a wider cord. For my cotton drawstring, I made 4. It's up to you. The only thing to keep in mind is that you will have to hold all the loops from the chains in your fingers, which I'll show you in a moment. So here is my second chain from my hook. I'll insert my hook into that second chain, yarn over and pull through. Then go into the next chain, which is my last chain. Yarn over and pull through. At this point, I have 3 loops on my hook. I like to twist my hook so that the hook part is facing down as I pull out all my loops except for the last one. You'll want to have just one loop left on your hook. And then I carefully pinch the loose loops between my thumb and middle finger. This is the tricky part, and once your fingers get comfortable knowing where to go with a little practice, it's a breeze. So take a look at my hands. In my case, I hold my hook in my right hand, so my right hand is just holding the hook as usual. And in my left hand, my thumb and middle finger are gripping the loops. And my pointer finger is in the position where it usually is when I'm crocheting, slightly raised and keeping a comfortable tension coming from my yarn. Then release the next loop, insert your hook into it, yarn over and pull through. And do the same with your next, in my case, last loop. Yarn over and pull through. Now I'm at the end of my row and I've got 3 loops on my hook again. I do the same thing for this and every row. I pull off every loop except for the last one. Then I yarn over and pull through. Pick up the next loop. Yarn over and pull through. And pick up the next loop, yarn over, and pull through. I'm going to keep doing this several more times so you can just absorb what I'm doing. First, it won't seem like your piece is going to be round, but after you do a handful of rows, you'll start to see it taking that round cord shape. It's helpful to keep a small hook or other tool nearby that you can use to pull out any of your loose loops if they start to get lost. And you just continue working in the same way until you get to your desired length. If you'd like to change colors, the only thing you do differently is at the point after you pull out your hook and begin the first yarn over. Just use your new piece of yarn. After you get the first few stitches, you can pull the loose ends to tighten it down, and keep going in exactly the same way. When you're ready to finish your cord and you're at the end of your row with all the loops pulled onto your hook, I'm showing you here my final piece. You just yarn over and pull through all the loops. Then chain one, cut your yarn leaving a tail, and pull through. Then give it a tug to tighten. The nice thing about sewing your tails in with I-cords is weaving isn't necessary. You can just run your needle right down the inside of the cord and cut the remaining tail. If you're planning on using your I-cord as a drawstring, make sure the openings are large enough to fit your cord. I used a marker to slightly stretch out the opening so the cord would easily feed through. And then if you have a drawstring threader, you can just run it through. My cord is too big for the eye of the threader, so I used a safety pin to join them. If you don't have a threader, you can just put a safety pin on the end and use it to slowly inch your way through the drawstring channel. If you'd like to make barrel knots on the end, be sure to crochet your cord a bit longer. Each of my knots used about 14 inches or about 35.5 centimeters of cord. Leave a couple inches or so for a tail. Wrap the cord around two fingers as many times as you like. I did 5. And then bring your tail through the top. Pull both ends and sort of massage the rounds into place. I don't pull too hard because I want to keep the barrel knot looking nice and fluffy. Then you'll just repeat at the other end and the drawstring I-cord is complete. Thanks for watching! See you next time!